Okay, it's TLB time again. Today with me, Kim. Tomorrow we will do a regular draft, but I will do one more of these speed drafts before that. Crawling Sensation, I like in Delirium, but I'm not first picking it. Angelic Purge feels more safe to start off with, and I will be more open. We have Double Stitch Mangler, Researcher, I guess Quilled Wolf, Cult of the First Moon, or what it's called. Watching something. But I like Stitch Mangler in... I mean, blue is not that drafted because the pros say it's bad. So I find it to be often open and then I can just have all the cards. Another Angelic Purge could take Pour Over Pages and Reckless Scholar. But I think I like to have the real good removal spells early because then I can choose between different type of creatures and spells. Yeah, we do that. We might wheel a fox or maybe a homunculus. And I heard Marshall from Limited Resources talk about his white-blue tempo deck. I've drafted a lot of tempo. Yeah, we're taking a Qatar here, which goes there. I've played a lot of tempo decks, but not as much white-blue, so might just try that out. You go for evasive creatures like this Geist or Nibelis of Dusk. I'm taking the Geist because it's harder to get by than the Dusk, I think. You often get Nibblers later just because it's blue and, yeah, often comes later in the packs. Yeah, you take evasive creatures and then you take stuff that just taps down, holds something tapped down, bounces stuff, and like the, like Expose Evil, for example. Tap something down, investigate. You get the card back and you get the tempo swing. So basically you take evasive creatures, Stitch Manglers to tap stuffing down, I guess bounce spells, Nibblies of Dusk is good. Drownyard Explorer is not really for that deck. You could play it, I guess. You prefer flying creatures. As two drops you can just play the Delirium 2-2, the Skulk guy, and so on. And if you're lucky, you could also get a sub-theme of spirits in a deck like that, because white-blue is spirits, yeah, and we got a late Homunculus. So we already have a lot of playables. I guess Silver Strike and Jace's Scrutiny is more for defensive decks. I don't think they're that good in a tempo deck, unless you face another even more aggro deck, and then you might side them in. But we're keeping them in for now. Yeah, and I was thinking now I need two drops, and this guy is good. A 2-2 for two, and it has very high upside if it's left on the board, and I curve with creatures, because then it just turns into a star-star that puts in a human each turn. Super duper. Here, I could take like the 2-4 flyer or a 3-1, but I think the Mythic Hydra could be the new ramp standard playable, so I might just take it and keep it if it grows a lot in value, and then I can just sell it later. I don't think I'm missing out that much. We'll probably wheel one of the cards here either way. Yeah, Stitch Mangler is decent here. A good evasive creature that you could get back if you're flooded in the late game. The four drops you really like to have flying in this deck if they're not like super relevant, like Odric or something. Could take that, just to steal something. Maybe they have a 4-1, a 3-1, a 2-2, a 3-2, or whatever that stands in my way somehow. They have their own Nibblies of Dusk or something. Then I can just steal it, and that's also like a tempo swing, so it fits the theme. Uninvited Geist is decent here also. It has pseudo invasion, and then if you flip it, it's actually unblockable. So yeah, 3-3 unblockable, and now yeah, also a bounce spell. So now we have already a lot of ways to get, and actually Puncturing Light is also good because early you want to be able to both play like a removal spell or a tempo spell and develop your board at the same time. So just attacking, then blocking, you remove it and you keep your guy is actually good in this deck. Could take the land for potential splash. I don't want to play the 5 mana tempo swing. It's a bit expensive. I guess you could if you don't have anything to play, but I'd rather just play a Scrutiny then, I think, and get my card back for more cheap mana cost. So as I said, we wield like three of the cards from that pack. So yeah, we take a 3-1, hoping to just play a flyer there. But I could play the companion if I don't get anything better. So we already have a lot of ways to remove blockers out of the way. Double purge, bounce, three tappers, one control magic card, and also like stuff in the sideboard that could be relevant. Yeah, 16 playables and some more, I mean, in the side as well. I would like another Stitchwing Scab. I like my 4-drops to be very impactful here and fit the theme of just being evasive and have more power than toughness. Pretty boring pack, but I do need more 2-drops, so I could just take the Skulk guy. Probably another Nibelis of Dusk, because all my 3-drops now, if I get like one more, I could maybe just take out the Qatar and play all flyers or at least evasive creatures. So it looks decent here, I think. And here I could take like a Sleep Paralysis. It's fine in the deck, but I would like to try out the 5-mana counterspell. Doesn't really fit the theme very good, but I mean, late game and taking another Stitch Mangler here, it's awesome in this deck. Just countering something and have 3 cards to draw if you're out of gas. And it's very annoying to play against, so I'm taking it and see if we run it. Yeah, I'm taking the Inspector here because an early drop and Investigate is very good. And also the Drifter is perfect. We could, it's not impossible to get Delirium with all the instant sorceries and purges and stuff like that. Vessel is decent. I guess you can play like one of them in this deck. The 2 flyers is relevant. Yeah, we're already up to 22 good cards, I think. And actually, the Fox is not bad. A 2-drop that's very heavy and punishes slow draws. And even if they can manage to put out like one big blocker or something, you can just tap it down, bounce it, remove it. You get the picture. So yeah, I guess this is probably, we don't have any super duper bombs, we don't have maybe the Spirit Lords or Flash Spirits on rare and stuff like that, but we have the good commons and uncommons, and I do think this deck is about what you want when you are talking about white blue tempo. And yeah, let's try it out. I think it can be good. We have like 15, 16 creatures counting the vessel. Almost all our creatures are good early drops or evasive threats. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I guess 6, 7 ways to get a blocker out of the way. And we can also steal something. And we have the annoying late game counterspell. And we could also board in more creatures if we need, more tappers if we need, or just a scrutiny if we need to be a bit more defensive. I guess the mana here is like 9-8 for one of the colors. I guess white has some more early drops, so I could go 9-8 on white, I guess. Yeah, I think this looks like it has potential. I'm going to submit it and record a match. Let's see you there.